Hey, Gospel Light, your missions pastor, Scott Mercer here, and I'm so excited for us to be able to share a few more testimonies from the Community Compassion Campaign. We have really been seeing a lot of people reach out to the church via the website, both to help out and also some with needs. And I wanted to share one quick testimony. Our small group got the name of a lady who lives about 30 minutes away, and she was in desperate need of some groceries. And so our small group raised the money, and I went out there with my brother-in-law, Brad, and we pulled up to this lady's house, and she came out, and it was incredible to see how much these groceries meant to her. And I just couldn't help but thinking about what a statement it was that we were being the church, that we were living out the gospel, that we were partnering with our small group to share Christ with this lady who was in need during this difficult time. We stood on the porch with this lady, and she told us about her struggles during this time. Her son got laid off. Her other son is going through a divorce right now. And she has grandchildren. She stood there on the porch and told us that she has grandchildren, and she doesn't know what's going to happen to them, and she's very worried for them. And it wasn't some soppy story where she started weeping or anything like that, but she just had a great need, and we were able to fill it. She has not attended church since she moved to Arkansas, and so that was kind of cool to get to talk to her a little bit about that. And she was a Christian. She said she is trusting in Jesus Christ alone for her hope of eternal life, but it was just neat to be a part of that. So I want to encourage you, if you have not yet gone to our church website, to go and sign up to be a volunteer, or if you are in need of help, feel free to go on and request help.
Hello, Gospel Light. I sure have missed being able to see each of you, but have enjoyed our online services. I wanted to share today about the Community Compassion Project. I went online and signed up to be a volunteer, just not sure of how it was going to all work out, but I wanted to give back to our community in some way. So last week, I received a call from the office about one of our neighbors in need, who is a single mom of two little girls and is expecting a child later on this year. And what was neat about it is a donation had been made for her to the church. And so I was contacted just to be the deliverer. So I made connection with this neighbor in need and set up a time to meet her. And so I arrived, of course, with the social distancing guidelines in place, met her on her front porch, and we got to visit for just a short little while, and she explained her situation a little bit, told me about her girls, and we were able to connect and see how that God was still touching her and providing for her during this difficult season of life. And so we prayed together and shared about the Easter services and how that she could stay connected with our Gospel Light community that way as well. So after the prayer, I even tried to encourage her to pay it forward in her small little community where she lived, just to show that how that God had provided for her and how that he would do the same for her neighbors in need as well. So just remember, Gospel Light, to be good to everybody, because everybody's having a tough time.
Hello, everyone. My name is Lauren Hoffman, and I get to attend Gospel Light Baptist Church, and I get to teach first and second grade. And our church has been doing this community compassion outreach to bless those in our community, and it's been so fun just to get to be a part of it and get to help out others in need, and just to, you know, get to meet new people and share the gospel with them. And on Saturday, Samantha Porter, Gloria Ann, which is Preacher Miss Capacey's daughter, and myself were out visiting our students. And while we were out, we actually made a stop at Walmart and picked up some groceries for a family that lives out close to Malvern. And when we went and delivered them to them, we weren't quite sure what to expect. But when we knocked on the door, a sweet lady came to the door, and she invited us inside, and we got to talk with them and just invite them to the services online. And it was just so much fun to get to do that together. And I want to share a verse with you. The Bible says in Luke 6:38, "Give and it shall be given unto you, good measure, pressed down and shaken together and running over shall men give into your bosom. For with what measure that ye meet, withal it shall be measured unto you again." And God always keeps his word, and he always returns to us whatever we give, whether it's maybe a money or a smile or an encouraging word. You can never outgive God. And so the neat thing was, as we were visiting our kiddos, you know, just seeing them because we missed them, without us even knowing, our parents gave us gift cards while we were out visiting them that totaled more than the amount that we had even paid for those groceries. And it just kind of showed us that, you know, God always gives us so much more than we could ever imagine. And so I just wanted to challenge everyone, maybe if you're thinking, well, I don't know if I have enough money to give or even time to give, you know, ask God, what is it that you would have me to give? Maybe it's not money, but, you know, would you have me to give some time that I could help somebody out? Because it's so much fun to just see God work and move in ways that only he can.